Welcome back, guys. Now we have got the La Liga team of the season. I think we only got like a couple of ones left. There would be the Italian league, then the French league as well. Is there something else that I'm missing, guys? I don't know. I mean, there could be a rest of the world, but I'm not really expecting one. Yeah, there's a La Liga tournament. La Liga tournament has some. Along with La Liga, there is the Turkish league as well. And that's a very nice card if you could win this one. And there's a. For the first time, as a tournament reward, we are getting a player with a legendary boost. So that's pretty cool. If you can win, if you can go all the way, then you could actually get a nice 90 Ferret and Griezmann card. And guys, along the La Liga team of the season, there is my all-time favorite player. But yeah, unfortunately, I definitely won't be able to get him. I mean, look at that card. He's 99 and that's... I don't know, I mean, I believe that at 100 overall, his acceleration and sprint speed would be maxed out. That finishing, short power, dribbling, ball control, agility, reactions, short passing. I mean, this is just an unreal card. But such a shame. We, the normal players, have no chance of getting him. I mean, these big prime icons, they're going to cost, I don't know, $500 or more. I mean, even Maldini or Gerrard would cost like $400 or $500. So I'm definitely not getting him. I wish they had packs like last season. There would be coin packs. I mean, there with a small chance of pulling these icons. And then if you're lucky, you could get them. I tried my luck with the La Liga reserves, you can see, a couple of times, and I got very bad pack luck. I got a couple of times the 85 rated Johnny. I mean, I know I should not have wasted my points there, but the thing was that most of my friends have been pulling amazing cards, and if you do that at the reset, like this 95 Ter Stegen, or the 95 rated, there's other card 95 rated from EPL, I mean, there's Ederson, and there's some other cards and all. When you pull them at reset, if you are the one of the first ones to pull them and then list them, you could sell them for 70 million, 90 million and all. So that's a lot of coins. I tried for that, but unfortunately, I got the 85 rated Johnny. I mean, even Johnny I sold for 2 million coins. So that's something big, I think. I mean, right now he would be like very cheap. Okay, so there's Ter Stegen, Yedder, Dembele. So that's it. Looks like a decent car, especially if you're a Barcelona fan, that would be a good one. But yeah, I'm not too happy with the 6'2 height. I want somebody who is 6'5 or above. In the Turkish Super League, in the Turkish team of season, there is a card, but he is extinct in my market. There is a 6'5" goalkeeper with the number one boost. I want to get him, but he is extinct in my market, unfortunately. It's a pretty good Dembele card as well. I mean, in the PlayStation and Xbox version, the console version of FIFA 19, he got the left wing card. I mean, I wish he had got the left wing card. This looks like an amazing card, but... left forward, I don't use that formation. I might get him for the tournament because he looks pretty good and I want to play the weekend tournament. I mean, there are no other weekend tournaments and all right now, so I'm just going to play the La Liga tournament and guys, some other cards. I mean, Messi, I'm not too happy with his skill boost, but then again, he is definitely sure to get the ultimate team of season. You can see here this team of season ultimate. So guys, the ultimate team of season is like there will be like 11 players who are the best. Like it's somewhat like the team of the year, you know, combined from all leagues. There will be players and 100% is sure. I mean, Messi is like the top scorer in all leagues this season, so he is definitely going to make it. So I'm pretty sure that card will get a legendary boost and that could be an amazing card. I mean, guys, the card art, they've done it amazing now. I mean, the lightning and all that stuff, the flashy ones, They're doing well in terms of card art, at least. I mean, at least that's one thing that's working for them. Other than that, there are some, again, some nice cards. But again, I'm not too happy with the skill boost of all of these cards, because I'm using a legendary skill boost squad. I mean, he has a legendary boost. Again, I'm not too impressed by him or the other ones. Okay, just Navas, he should be fast, I guess. Okay, and we're going to get 5 La Liga shards here. And guys, this team of season points, I'm spending them on getting legendary SBs, the legendary skill boosts, as soon as I get them. Okay, whom do we get? We get Jesus Navas shards. I want a Jordi Alba shards, because I'm going to get Jordi Alba. I mean, who is the best left back in the whole game? Of course, it's definitely the prime icon, Roberto Carlos. But again, that would cost a lot of real money. So we are definitely not even looking that way. So who is the next best? I was using Roberto Carlos normal version. He is good. And then there is Easter version of Alaba as well. Some nice options. But the Timothy season version of Jordi Alba is definitely the best available so far. Of course, the ultimate Timothy season may have another option. But I'm guessing that Robertson from Liverpool would get the ultimate Timothy season version. But yeah, I'm not going to wait for that. I'm going to get Jordi Alba. Because again, I don't see myself getting ultimate Timothy season once and all. Because yeah, unfortunately, only two, which means I have to waste some of those shards. Because ultimate Timo season ones would like more likely to cost a lot of real money, or I mean, you'll have to get a lot of points. I mean, even a 94 rated player is costing this much. So we can see there would be like 98 and 99 rated cards and all. And 99 Messi is costing like 420 points. So if that requires that kind of an amount of ultimate Timo season points, then I'm definitely not getting it. Okay, I can finally get Jordi Alba now. If you're lucky, you could get his flashy version or the premium version as well. Of course, these are not auctionable yet. For me, it doesn't matter too much which one I want to get right now, because anyway, I'm going to use them in the squad. Okay, here we go. We get 11 Timo season ultimate points, and we get a normal version of Jordi Alba as well. I mean, like we expected, getting that premium version would be like very difficult. I mean, those stats are just perfect. Let us take a look at his stats at 100 overall, when he's trained up maximum to the 100 overall. Okay, you can see his acceleration is 140. I mean, that's a maximum acceleration. So especially in head-to-head mode, he's going to help you a lot with 124 sprint speed. That is, wow guys, that's really good. I mean, if you're not getting a prime icon, I don't think you're going to get much better than this. He gets 140 marking, 140 standing tackle, 129 sliding tackle, 128 interceptions. Of course, the aggression could be a bit better later on for other cards, I think. I mean, for the ultimate Timo season left back, it has to be an unreal card if it is to be better than this one. I mean, look at that. 130 agility, 132 ball control, 119 dribbling, 91 curve. I mean, we could probably use this guy as an attacker and he would still do good. So I'm definitely happy with my choice. This is the first Timo season starter that I have got this season. None of the others have impressed me too much. The Timo season version of Sterling looks good as well, but other than that, this is one player that I find to be a huge improvement compared to the previous ones that I got. So yeah, definitely this guy is
definitely worth getting, especially if you're someone who loves playing the head-to-head mode, because there you definitely, I mean, even in VSA at the moment, acceleration and all matters a lot, so he could be probably the best choice available for the free-to-play players right now.
Bringing in Alba would make my squad a lot stronger than it is right now, and I'll most probably get, now that I don't really need Rashford for the UCL event, because yeah, they kind of ruined it, at least in my opinion. So I don't really need Rashford anymore, so I might just get that Sadio Mane, so that he's very fast at least. And I don't really want to spend like 70 million or 80 million on some left-wing player for VSA. I mean, at the moment, they're the only players with the second striker boost, that the one I want. So I'll most probably just get Sadio Mane and get over with it. And for central midfield, I think I'm going to go for Herrera as well from Manchester United, because again, I have enough XP to even get any player above 88. I already have a trained up player, so any player above 88 directly goes to Hunter. So I'm not going to go for Fabian. I think I'll go with Herrera. Or is there any other options you guys see, guys? I mean, if you have seen any other center midfielder with captain boost who is pretty good in game, let me know. And again, as for the goalkeeper, I want to shift to a goalkeeper who has number one boost. I mean, you can see my skill boost. I have most of the skill boost at 18, but the goalkeeper one is only at 13. I want to change it to the legendary boost as well. In this game, unfortunately, I mean, you look at a goalkeeper like Marc-Andre Ter Stegen of Barcelona. He's amazing in real life, but unfortunately, in the game, goalkeepers who are very tall, they seem to perform better. I mean, that's the reason why prime icon Van der Sar, and then I mean, of course, Van der Sar has unreal stats. There is that, but the height matters a lot. That's the reason Donnarumma, DDG, and even Courtois, they all perform well. Now there is a goalkeeper from Turkish league. I might get him if he becomes available in my market. Unfortunately, he cannot be claimed. The only way is like, if somebody opens those La Liga packs and all, and they somehow pack him and they sell him, then only we can get him from the market. If he is available, then I could finally change. I want to upgrade my squad in a way I could get all players to 100. I hope that happens soon. And guys, thanks a lot for your support. And of course, I know I should have maybe saved the gems and all, but I really wanted to. I have never opened a bundle before, so I wanted to try that one out. Yes, of course, it did not work then, but who knows? The leg thing is like that. We never know when it comes. I hope it comes soon for all of us. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye.